other subcommittees, Zane?
Yeah, I'll give the subcommittee for the modern streetcar and transit. Subcommittee Chairman Harding gave the members a homework assignment to provide their ideas, thoughts, recommendations, and possible proposals for routes for kicking off the streetcar. They did that and presented their ideas last night, and out of that it became apparent that a common spur or spine was coming to the forefront, and we're looking at that, and we're going to bring forth recommendations to identify these common areas or common themes or common paths so that we can get that information to Project 180 and that they can take consideration for the utilities, layout of utilities. So, Eric, when will those recommendations be presented to the board? And by board, I mean, when will they come forward to this committee?
So what I gained from last night was there were some preliminary recommendations. They'd worked for about 2 hours, and obviously there was a lot of input and a lot of thought, and as they wrapped up, they came to some common agreement. I think one of the things I'll share too is it's very close also to what the Alternatives Analysis Steering Committee has come up with, so there is some commonalities that are there. But we're going to work somewhat with the information that was provided last night, knowing that the two different groups have alignment. But I think what we wanted to reserve until the next meeting to do more of a confirmation process. There still was a couple small questions, I think, that were out there. But we'll be prepared to formalize that in more of such a place where we can actually get that up to the council's receiving it as well. And so we'll be prepared to do that hopefully over the next month.
In that discussion at the end of the meeting, they asked for a council perspective, and I was very, very encouraged, and I've been asked by several people, what's the modern streetcar system going to be? And I tell them this, that I'm committed, I think your council is committed, I hope you are committed, to having a roughly a 6-mile transportation system that will have rails that are in the ground that will be up to date in its design, and stay tuned for particulars later on. But the commitment is, because there were some questions, people said, are we committed to a modern streetcar with tracks in the ground? And I think the answer to that is emphatically, would you agree, Eric? Yes.
Yes.
So I think if you're approached by people about that, you need to give them that assurance, because in the past couple of weeks there's been some comments made that might, confuse some people. But
I'd like to add to that yes, right now the MAPS 3 part is just the 5 to 6 mile radius, but that by no means is the end of it. I think that we're thinking that beyond that, and where can it go beyond MAPS 3? So we're providing opportunity for that growth too.
So this is the seed to start mass transit, if you want, or public transit, or whatever you want to call it, throughout central Oklahoma. But this is what this project is focused on, that will spread. And the committee did an excellent job of taking a vision of what could be in the future and coming down the line. I'm going to be commended on that.